According to Oxford Dictionary, a tackle is an act of seizing and stopping a player in possession of the ball by knocking them to the ground. In American football and other common tackling sports, such as Canadian football and rugby, different tackles are used in a variety of ways to stop the offense from scoring. The basic types of tackles in these sports are listed in the following: behind the back tackle, face-to-face tackle, and diving tackles.
We chose a face-to-face tackle.
So first, you're going to do eye to the thighs. And that means you're going to put the side of your head and your shoulder into the thigh of who you're tackling. Next, you're going to wrap. And that means you're going to wrap both arms around their thighs. Then, you're going to drive for five, which means you're going to use your momentum and your force to try to drive them back as far as possible. And this is helpful in any tackling situation because this results in less yardage gained. And here's some examples of good and bad tackling.
This bad form of tackling is not wrapping. This is bad because the opponent will almost get away every time.
This is another example of bad tackling because the defender is spearing. This is an example of good tackling because it utilizes eyes to the thighs, wrapping, and driving for five.
On average, the linebacker is roughly 5 yards away from the quarterback. If our linebacker wanted to perform a sack, what would his acceleration be? We knew that Ben had to travel 4 yards, and he did this in roughly 1 second. Using this, we found that Ben was accelerating at about 2.5 meters per second squared. Our linebacker pushes off the ground with a significant force, but what is it? Instead of using the normal force equation, I used a scale and measured the force in pounds that Ben pushes off the scale. After some unit transversions, the force of our linebacker pushing off the ground was 880 newtons, which is roughly the force of, well, someone stomping on your hand.
Before we find the impact force of Ben sacking the dummy, we need to find the total velocity. To start, we will need the horizontal and vertical velocity. After we have those two numbers, we use everyone's favorite, Pythagorean's theorem. We use this because the total velocity is like the hypotenuse of our velocity triangle. In the end, Ben's total velocity is 6.7 meters per second, which is about the speed of a running bull.
Now's the moment you've all been waiting for. How hard is Ben hitting the dummy? After substituting answers from previous problems, we found that our linebacker was hitting the quarterback with a force of roughly 1,500 newtons, which is about the force required to break a 1.5-inch thick concrete slab with your fist.